Trump speeding up the border wall after what was just found there that sent agents running. Looks like we will be getting a border wall even sooner than we thought. The reports are currently sketchy, but it's being reported that an off-duty U.S. Border Patrol agent was discovered on the side of a roadway with serious injuries to his head, torso, and hands this past weekend. The agent seems to have been ruthlessly attacked. This particular Border Patrol agent is assigned to the Deming, New Mexico station, which is in the El Paso sector of the U.S.-Mexico border, an area that has seen a lot of movement of drugs from cartels and coyotes who get paid as much as $10,000 per person to sneak in illegals. This particular area is immediately south of the border area. This is currently being controlled by the Juarez Cartel and their enforcers, La Linea. The Juarez Cartel is considered one of the most ruthless and bloodiest cartels in all of Mexico. They currently operate in the El Paso sector and are famous for kidnapping people. If this wasn't bad enough, they are also master administrators of multiple torture techniques. It is not uncommon for people in Mexican border cities to wake up to a pile of dead bodies in the streets. Thankfully, we have a president now who understands what we are up against here. This isn't about race, religion, or our economy. This is about our very security. We have very dangerous individuals very close to our own borders, which are largely open for anyone to come in and make themselves at home. InsightCrime.org reports, violence in Ciudad Juarez is on the rise. This year is on track to be the deadliest since 2012, signaling the possible renewal of warfare between the region's dominant criminal groups. 7 people were killed and 1 injured in an October 27 attack at a motel in the city of Chihuahua, a few hours south of Ciudad Juarez on the highway that links the two cities. According to eyewitnesses, 4 men entered the motel at around 5:45 p.m. wielding heavy caliber weapons, and opened fire on the victims. Afterward, the assailants fled north, stopping to change vehicles, according to El Diario. Chihuahua Attorney General Cesar Augusto Penica said that both the victims and the perpetrators were members of criminal groups. The authorities have apprehended one of the individuals involved in the slaughter, according to Preciso. Additionally, 10 other people were killed that day in various attacks in Juarez, reported Preciso. Insight Crime Analysis: Juarez and the state of Chihuahua have seen rising levels of violence in recent months, raising speculation that the dark days of brutal killings that the city saw in between the years 2008 and 2012 could be making a comeback. Just in the month of October, there have been 90 homicides in Juarez, and 183 in the state of Chihuahua, according to Preciso. Mexico's army, which many human rights activists have blamed, at least in part, for a spike in violence that began in 2008, was sent back onto the streets of Juarez in August this year. At the current pace, 2016 will be most violent year in Juarez since 2012, according to Mexican security analyst Alejandro Hope, who also noted that violence is not confined to Juarez, and that murders have been on the rise around the state of Chihuahua. The level of brutality and style of the killings, notes Hope, are reminiscent of those seen during the 2008 to 2012 war between the Juarez and Sinaloa cartels. The notion that the conflict between the two groups could be revived was lent credence via an interview the newspaper El Universal recently conducted with Jorge, a leader of La Linea, the line, the enforcement ring of the Juarez cartel. Jorge said that the latest rise in homicides were just the beginning. According to him, war is returning to Juarez and the worst is yet to come. Gustavo Fondvila, a security expert, told Inside Crime that it is likely that the possible extradition to the United States of Sinaloa cartel leader Joaquim El Chapo Guzman has weakened the crime group and disrupted its control in Juarez. When criminal groups contest strategically important territories like Juarez, which is a major transshipment point for drugs headed to the United States, violence tends to increase, Fondvila said. So next time liberals start their incessant whining about how we patriotic Americans are intolerant and bigoted, just ask them why they want our great nation to turn into the cesspool that is Mexico. Sure, Mexico has its great areas with great people and safety. But we all know the vast majority of ordinary people, like most of us, will never be able to afford to live there. Please share if you support President Trump's wall.
Please do not forget like on videos, and subscribe, and comment because your voice matters, and visit our page on Facebook, and like them, and follow up. And thanks for watching.